I'm so happy to see you. Oh, and so is Dorothy. Say hello, Dorothy. Oh, guess what Elmo's thinking about today? Oh, it's raining. Did you guess yet? Rain, snow, wind, sun, it's all rubbish! You know, weather! Whoa, Elmo's a little under the weather. Weather too, and Dorothy has a question. What? Oh, okay. What do you wear when it rains? Oh, good question, Dorothy. Let's ask Mr. Noodle. Mr. Noodle! Whoa, sounds like thunder. Is it gonna rain? Oh, go up, Shay. Let's see. Come on, Shay. Oh, it's Mr. Noodle. Hi, Mr. Noodle. Hi. Oh, it's thundering. Oh, and now it's starting to rain. Mr. Noodle? Mr. Noodle?
What do you wear when it rains?
Uh-oh. You need a raincoat, Mr. Noodle.
No, that's a swimsuit, Mr. Noodle.
That's for swimming.
That's what you wear under the water.
Mr. Noodle, get a raincoat.
You don't wear that when it's raining.
You need a raincoat for the rain.
And a rain hat.
Try again, Mr. Noodle.
Mr. Noodle?
That's a winter coat and a sled.
What do you wear in the rain? To keep dry, Mr. Noodle.
What's he going to do with the sled?
You don't use a sled in the rain.
Sleds are for the snow, not the rain.
Oh, Mr. Noodle, you forgot your sled.
Yay, you did it.
Good job, Mr. Noodle.
You wear a raincoat.
Now open the umbrella.
You're still getting wet. Come on, Mr. Noodle.
You have to open it, Mr. Noodle.
Upside down.
Mr. Noodle.
Not like that.
Hold the handle.
Yeah, like that.
Yay, hey, Mr. Noodle.
What's he doing?
Can dance.
Oh, very nice, Mr. Noodle. That Mr. Noodle, he's all wet. What's that? What's that? Say it again, Dorothy. Oh, okay. Dorothy wants to ask someone else. What do you wear when it rains?
Hi, Dorothy. This is what I wear in the rain, my rain poncho.
Hi, Dorothy. This is what I wear when it rains. My raincoat, my boots, and my umbrella keeps me dry.
This is what I wear when it rains, Dorothy. My raincoat, my rain hat, and my boots, so I can keep my feet dry. Then I can jump in puddles like this.
Thanks, everybody. Oh, and thanks, Dorothy. Now, Emma will ask a baby. Hello, baby. What do you wear when it rains? Oh, thank you, baby. It's raining again. Elmo loves to wear his umbrella hat when it rains. Oh, no. It stopped raining. Oh, well. So
Elmo
now...
Elmo has mail. Elmo has mail.
Email. Elmo has mail. Elmo wants an email. Elmo computer. Has computer. Has Elmo has mail. Hey, Elmo wait a minute. Mail. Elmo doesn't have
mail.
To run.
Elmo has mail.
Stop, computer.
Elmo has
stop.
Mail. Elmo has mail.
Good. Oh, it's Elmo's friend Oscar who sent Elmo email.
You want to know what grouches like to wear in the rain? Nothing. I like to get wet and soggy. I like everything in my trash can to get wet and soggy. That's why I keep the lid up. Oh, and elephants like the rain, too. They like to splash in the puddles. Oh, this is a beautiful day. Now scram. Wait a minute. I'm sending this email. I'll scram.
Thanks for the message, computer. And now... Oh, no, 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 no. Oh, oh boy. Door. And now, Elmo has a question for you. Yeah, you. How many leaves are blowing in the wind? Let's count them and see.
One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten, 11, 12, 13, 14.
Oh, 14 leaves blowing in the wind.
You can. You can count the falling snowflakes. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Oh, it's a winter wonderland of counting.
Thanks, Troy. Elmo's friend Alex knows a lot of different things you can do in the snow, and he told Elmo all about it.
I woke up in the morning, and it had snowed. It's great and winter when it snows. Everything was covered with snow. My mom helped me put on my snowsuit because it was cold outside. I fastened up my snow boot and we ran outside. There's so many things you can do in the snow. We made footprints. Animals make footprints too. I made a snow angel. The snow was cold. After that, my mom and I made a snowman. I put on his nose. We also had a snow fight. It was fun. Then we went sledding. I put on my helmet. I slid down the hill really fast. I didn't get too far. But I tried again. And again. And again. Sledding is great.
Yeah!
By the end of the afternoon, I got tired. Then we went home, and Mom made hot chocolate. I love hot chocolate.
And I love the snow.
Elmo loves the snow, too. Oh, thanks, Alex. Oh, but Elmo still wants to learn more, don't you? How can we find out more? TV. Oh, yeah, yeah. We can watch the Weather Channel. Oh, turn yourself on, TV.
The Weather Channel blowing into your home. And now, the Weather Lady and the Four Seasons.
Hello, I'm the Weather Lady and this is my dog, Sunny Boy. We both love the weather. All kinds.
Woof, woof, woof.
He's not just a fair weather friend. Ah,
woof.
We love the seasons too. All four of them.
Woof, 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 woof.
Take summer. The weather outside is hot and sunny. And sometimes it gets too hot in the summer to do anything except swim. Ooh, they don't call them dog days for nothing. After summer, autumn comes. It gets colder and windy. The leaves turn beautiful colors. And then they fall off the trees. Hey, that's what autumn is sometimes called. Fall. Leave it to Sunny Boy. Then it gets even colder and winter sets in. Sometimes it snows. Doesn't it, Sunny Boy? Then it starts to get warmer and the snow melts. And it's spring. Not too hot, not too cold. Just a little wet. It rains so flowers and plants can grow. Sometimes it rains so hard, even the weather lady has to go inside. Yes, you too, Sunny Boy. I love the weather. Whether it's summer or fall, winter or spring, and so does Sunny Boy. That's right, Dave.
Coming up on the Weather Channel, a snowman for all seasons. Catch it before it melts.
Thanks, TV. But Elmo wants to learn even more about weather, don't you? How can we find out even more? Who could that be? Whoa! Whoa!
Wanna talk to a tornado?
Whoa! Any M!
I'm a storm with lots of strong wind.
Elmo can see that! Whoa! And tornado's too windy! So tornado has to go! Go, go, go! Whoa! Whoa! Go, go! Go, go, go! Go, tornado! Go! Boy!
You can't play outside when I'm around.
Boy, tornado's not kidding!
But most of the time, you can have a little fun in the weather.
Oh, really?
Sure. You can even play sports.
What sports?
Depends on the weather. If it's a nice windy day, it's great to go wind surfing.
Oh, no! Dorothy's imagining Elmo wind surfing!
When there's snow, it's great to go skiing.
Thanks, tornado.
You're welcome. Let's twist again sometime.
Okay, bye-bye. Woo! Oh, Elmo loves weather. Oh, and so does Dorothy. That's why Dorothy wants us to sing the weather song. Here we go. Do-do-do, do-do-do-do. Snow! Wind!
Mr. Noodle!
He stopped at the door!
Be careful!
ask someone else. How do you get dressed?
Hi, Dorothy. This is how I put on my socks. First, you pull it up. Then you pull it down. Now I do the other one. You pull it up again. And then you pull it down. And that's how you do it, Dorothy.
When it's cold, I put on my sweatshirt like this, Dorothy. First, I pull it over my head, then I put one arm through, and then I put the other arm through. See? Like that, Dorothy.
This is how you put on snow pants, Dorothy. First, you put one leg in. Then you put your other leg in. Then you tuck your shirt in. You snap it. Zipper it. Then you tighten it. That's how you put on snow pants, Dorothy.
Thanks, kids. Oh, and thanks, Dorothy. Now, Elmo is going to ask a baby. Oh, hello, baby. How do you get dressed, baby? Here. Oh, thank you, baby. And now, Elmo has a question for you. Yes, you. How many pairs of pants are marching by? Let's count them and see.
Rubber Ducky wanted to tell you that he likes getting dressed sometimes. Mm-hmm. What's that, Rubber Ducky? Oh, okay. He's still getting dressed. Okay, Rubber Ducky. He's dressed now. He's dressed as a police officer. See his little blue police shirt and tie and his little police hat? Officer Ducky, you are a credit to your community. What's that, Officer Ducky? Oh, Officer Ducky says, let's quack this case. Oh, that Officer Ducky, he never misses a beat. Bye-bye, Elmo. Say goodbye.
Good night. Thanks, computer. Police officers wear blue shirts and ties when they get dressed for their jobs. That makes Elmo wonder, what do other people wear when they get dressed for their jobs? Elmo wants to know. Don't you? Let's find out. Draw a little help. A little help. Whoa! What do firefighters wear when they get dressed to put out fires? A bathing suit?
No.
A tutu?
No.
A firefighter's uniform?
Yes.
To protect them.
Yeah. Gets dressed in a firefighter's uniform. What do astronauts wear when they get dressed to go into space? A scuba diving suit?
No.
A baseball uniform?
No.
A space suit?
Yes.
An astronaut gets dressed in a space suit. What do worms wear when they get dressed?
Worms don't get dressed.
Unless it's slimy and he can wear whatever he wants. Looking good, Slimy. Put a stare, eat your heart out. Grouches gets dressed all by herself. And then she helps her baby sister get dressed too. And she told Elmo all about it.
I'm 7 years old, and I can get dressed all by myself. It's easy. But my sister Ariana is a baby, and babies are too little to dress themselves. Sometimes I help Ariana get dressed. First, my dad changes Ariana's diapers. Babies wear diapers. Then I put on her t-shirt. Sometimes we play. Where is Ariana?
Where's Ariana?
There she is. We help Ariana put her arms through the sleeves. Then we put on her overalls. They have snaps.
They can be kind of tricky.
Babies have really little feet.
Ariana's favorite socks
have butterflies and numbers on them. Then we put on her shoes. There she is, dressed up and ready to go. Someday, Ariana will be old enough to get dressed all by herself. But until then, I'll be here to help her.
Nice job, Alexis! Now, Elmo wants to learn even more about getting dressed, don't you? How can we learn more? Yeah! We can watch the Getting Dressed channel. Hey, even TV got dressed today. Oh, turn around and let us see you, TV. Oh, wow. TV looks very nice. Oh, turn yourself on. Thank
you. Welcome to the Getting Dressed channel. We're a really great outfit. Now it's time for a song about getting dressed.
I love getting dressed. If you love getting dressed, then I got a song that'll knock your socks off. Come on, let's sing and get dressed. If you've already dressed, you can pretend to get dressed. I put my legs in my pants. I put my legs in my pants. You put your legs in your pants, you'll be doing a dance.
Next on the Getting Dressed channel, Socks and the City, followed by Shall We Pants, starring Shirt Reynolds.
Thank you, TV. Thank you. Oh, look. Elmo got dressed with the song. But Elmo still wants to learn more about getting dressed. How can Elmo find out more?
Why not look in a book?
Where's the book? Oh, yeah, can book tell Elmo more about getting dressed?
Sure. My title is The History of Getting Dressed.
Oh, boy! Open up and let's see what's inside, Book.
Okay. Back in cave person days, people got dressed in cave person clothes.
Wow! A dressed cave person!
Later in ancient Rome, people got dressed in togas.
Imagining Elmo dressed in a toga. Toga! 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 Toga!
In medieval times, people got dressed in clothes made of metal. They were called knights in shining armor.
This is heavy metal.
In Scotland, people got dressed in skirts called kilts. And they still do.
Buck knows a lot about getting dressed.
Well, I try to cover everything.
Elmo loves getting dressed. Oh, and so does Dorothy. That's why Dorothy wants us to sing the Getting Dressed song.
Hey, I love that song. May I join in?
Sure. Here we go.
Getting dressed, getting dressed, getting dressed.
Sing along if you want.
Bye, Book again.
Bye. Now it's time to brush our teeth.
Family!
Now it's time to check the mail. Right here, Dorothy? Okay. Oh, hi. Welcome to Elmo's World. Oh, Elmo's so happy to see you. Oh, and so is Dorothy. Say hello, Dorothy. Oh, guess what Elmo's thinking about today? Look at the day. Whoa, what's that? Let's go and see. Come on. Mail! Wow! You know, mail! Oh, keep those cards and letters coming in!
Basketball, it's a letter.
You don't dunk a letter.
That's not how you mail a letter. That's how you play basketball.
Try again.
Hey, where'd the basket go?
What, a waste basket? No, Mr. Noodle.
That's a trash can. Trash can is for garbage.
You can't mail a letter that way.
You need a mailbox.
You need to find a mailbox, Mr. Noodle. Yeah, go and find a mailbox.
Yay, you found one.
Wow, he's strong.
You need to mail the letter in the mailbox. Mail it in the mail.
No!
That's under the mailbox.
You need to put it inside the mailbox.
In.
No, that's on top of the mailbox.
Not on the mailbox, in the mailbox.
Pull the handle to open it. It's in the front.
You can do it.
There's the handle.
Now put the letter in there. Put it in.
Now put it in the mailbox. Yeah.
Yeah, that's it. Put it in.
Put it.
No, you have to let go of the letter.
No, Mr. Noodle.
You need to put it inside, Mr. Noodle.
Now put it in.
Let it go.
Yay, Mr. Noodle did it!
Uh-oh. What's happening?
What's going on with the mailbox?
It's alive.
Oh, be careful. Oh, Mr. Noodle, what are you doing?
Oh, he's taking off.
Oh, it's airmail. Oh, Elmo gets it. Airmail.
Hold on, Mr. Noodle.
You're so silly. Yeah. Dorothy wants to ask someone else. How do you mail a letter?
Hi, Dorothy. This is a letter I wrote to my best friend, Max. And here's how I mail it. I open the door and I put it in the mailbox. And that's how I mail a letter, Dorothy.
Dorothy, this is how I mail a birthday card to my grandmother. First, I put the letter in the envelope. Then I lick it closed. After that, I put the stamp on the envelope and put it in the mailbox. See, I put the flag up so the mail carrier knows there's mail inside. That's it, Dorothy.
Thank you, everybody. Oh, and thank you, Dorothy. Now, Elmo will ask a baby. Hello, baby. Hi. Baby, how do you mail a letter? Oh, thank you, baby. And now, Elmo has a question for you. Oh, how many stamps are in a stamp stampede? Let's count them and see. Stamps. Okay, you have
one, two, three, four, five, six, seven.
Oh, seven stamps. And one very big package. Yeah. Where you going, package? Wow, smart stamps. Must be special delivery. Cool, great counting, everybody. But Elmo hopes Elmo gets more mail soon. Oh, yay!
Elmo has mail.
Elmo's got email. That's another
Elmo
kind of mail. Oh, computer.
Elmo has mail.
Computer, stop. Come back, computer.
Elmo has mail. Elmo has mail.
Computer. Elmo's going to get computer.
Mail.
Computer.
Elmo has Elmo has mail.
Stop, computer.
Elmo has mail.
Good computer. Okay, mouse. Oh, Elmo's got email from his friend Big Bird.
Hi, Elmo. Say hello, Radar. I'm checking my mailbox to see if I got any mail. Oh, look. It's for you, Radar. It's a postcard. And guess who it's from? Me! And it says, Dear Radar, wish you were here. Oh, you are here. Love, Big Bird. He just loves getting mail.
mail? Let's find out. Oh, open up drawer. Oh, that was easy. Can you get an ice cream cone in the mail?
No.
It would melt.
Ew. Oh, messy. Can you get a tiger in the mail?
No.
But you can get a postcard from India where tigers live. Can you get a birthday cake in the mail?
No.
But you can get a birthday card. Can you get cookies in the mail?
Yes.
Cowabunga! And you get box too. Me love postal service.
Thanks, Thor. Elmo loves getting mail as much as Cookie Monster. And Elmo's friend Jennifer likes sending it. Oh, she sent out her birthday invitations, and she told Elmo all about it. Oh, let's watch, Troy.
I'm having a birthday party soon. And I made my own birthday invitations to send to my friends. I put them in envelopes. I even decorated the envelopes myself. My mom helped me write the addresses of where my friends live. Then, all I needed were stamps. My mom took me to the post office to buy some. We waited in line. When it was our turn, I got to pick out the kind of stamps I wanted. There are lots of different kinds. I picked the ones with flowers on them. They were really pretty. Then I put the stamps on the envelopes. And then I put the invitations in the mailbox. I hope my friends get the invitations. And I really hope they can come to my party. Wait till they see the great decorations I'm making.
Oh, thanks for the invitation, Jennifer. Boy, Elmo really likes it. But now Elmo wants to find out more about mail, don't you? How can we find out more? Are you okay, Kiwi? Yeah, Elmo knows we can watch the mail channel. Are you sure you're okay, Kiwi? Okay, turn yourself on.
The Mail Channel, where you can get mail 24 hours a day. We deliver. And now on the Mail Channel, the story of a letter.
Once upon a time, yesterday, little Billy Postmeyer wrote a letter to his grandma in Toledo. And guess who that letter was? That's right, yours truly, me. And then it happened, what every letter dreams of. Little Billy put a stamp on me. That tickles. And then he mailed me.
Whoa!
My journey had begun. Inside the mailbox, there were lots of other letters and packages going to places all over the world.
I'm going to the North Pole.
I'm going to South America.
Wow.
And where are you going, Junior?
I'm going to Grandma's house.
Wow. Lucky you.
All of a sudden, the mailbox opened. Grandma, is that you?
Nah, that's the letter carrier. He's gonna take us to the post office.
Before I could say postage due, I was sorted.
Whoa!
The next thing I knew, I was on an airplane to Toledo.
Hey, I'm supposed to be going first class.
I thought I'd never get to Grandma's house. But before I could say return to sender, the plane landed in Toledo. And later, another letter carrier delivered me to Grandma's mailbox. Grandma, is that you?
A letter from Billy.
Boy, Grandma sure was glad to get me. And that's my story. Being a letter is very rewarding.
Coming up next on the Mail Channel, The Scarlet Letter, followed by Lady and the Stamp.
Hi, thanks, Stevie.
Now Elmo really wants to know more about mail, don't you? But how can we find out more?
Hey, want to talk to a mailbox?
A mailbox, yeah!
No one knows more about mail than I do. I get all kinds of mail.
Really? What kinds?
Oh, packages, magazines, letters, invitations. Oh boy, I just can't get enough. Yum, yum.
Oh, well, what kind of mail does mailbox like best?
Junk mail! Oh, boy, you got anything to mail?
No, not right now.
Oh, that's too bad, because if you did, you would put it right in here.
Oh, yes, Elmo sees.
And then the letter carrier would come and take it out of here. And that's one way mail gets from one place to another. Another way mail gets from one place to another is by airplane.
Oh, look, mailbox. Dorothy's imagining Elmo delivering mail on a plane.
Ooh!
Elmo delivering!
At long last, I can finally feather my nest. Thank you!
And that's how mail gets from one place to another.
Oh, thanks, mailbox. Wow, Elmo really loves mail. Oh, and Dorothy does too. That's why Dorothy wants us to sing the mail song.
Ooh.
Here we go. Yeah.
May I sing?
Oh, sure.
Mail, mail, mail. Mail, mail, mail. Mail, 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 mail. Mail, mail, mail. Mail, mail, mail. Mail, 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 mail.
Rub-a-dub-dub. It's back. Elmo loves you. Elmo has two ears. One, two. Oh, hi. Welcome to Elmo's world. Elmo's so happy to see you. Oh, and so is Dorothy. Say hello, Dorothy. Guess what Elmo's thinking about today? Ears. Yeah. You know, ears. Elmo is all ears. Wow. Mr. Noodle. Hi, Mr. Noodle. Hi.
Mr. Noodle, ready for Dorothy's question? Good. How do you wiggle your ears, Mr. Noodle?
No!
That's your nose, not your ears.
The ears are on the side of your head.
How do you wiggle your ears, Mr. Noodle?
What's he doing with his foot? He's wiggling his toes.
Those are your toes, not your ears.
Wiggle your ears, Mr. Noodle.
But that's very good toe wiggling.
That tickles.
You can do it.
Find your ears. On the side of your head, Mr. Noodle.
No, you don't have to spin, Mr. Noodle.
You got it.
That's an ear. Now find the other one.
On the other side.
That's two.
Now wiggle them back and forth.
No. He's shaking his whole head.
Oh, be careful, Mr. Noodle.
Try again, Mr. Noodle. Wow, those are big ears. Going, 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 going.
Good job, Mr. Noodle. What's that, Dorothy? Okay. Dorothy wants to ask someone else. How do you wiggle your ears?
Hi, Dorothy. This is how I wiggle my ears.
Dorothy, this is how I move my ears.
Oh, that's cool. Thanks, everybody. Oh, and thank you, Dorothy. Now, Elmo will ask a baby. Hello. Baby? How do you wiggle your ears, baby? Go ahead. Go ahead, baby. Oh, thank you, baby. Look, Dorothy, Elmo can wiggle his ears. Now, hear this. Elmo has a question for... What's that? Elmo hears something with his ears. Well, it sounds like... Oh, it is! Yes! A marching band!
I'm with the band.
Oh, that's nice. Bye-bye, bye-bye. Wow, music to Elmo's ears. Now, where was Elmo? Oh, yeah. And now, Elmo has a question.
Elmo has mail. Elmo has mail.
It's Elmo's computer.
Elmo has mail. Elmo has mail. Elmo has mail.
Elmo has
mail.
Elmo has mail. Stop, computer.
Elmo has mail.
Thank you. Okay, mouse. Oh, boy, it's email from Elmo's friend the elephant.
Hi, Elmo. I love ears. I especially love songs about ears. Here's my favorite. Do your ears hang low? Do they wobble to and fro? Can you tie them in a knot? Can you tie them in a bow? Do they dangle to your toes? Can they wrap around your nose? Do your ears hang low? Thanks, Elmo. Goodbye.
Do your ears hang low? Oh, thank you, computer. Thank you. Boy, that was a great ear song, wasn't it? And now, Elmo has a question for you. Yeah, you. How many pieces of popcorn do you hear popping? We'll count them with our ears. Popcorn machine. Oh, there you are, popcorn machine. Okay.
One, two, three, four, five, six.
your people sing to you on your birthday?
Pieces out of battle, nobody can deny.
Can you hear an ear of corn?
No!
Not unless it's popcorn! Pop, 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 pop. Can you hear a cookie?
No!
Unless Cookie Monster's eating it.
Me take that. Ha! Music to me tummy.
Thanks, Troy. Elmo's friends. Now what is Elmo hearing? Do you hear that squeaky sound? Do you think it's a mouse? Let's see. Ah! Look at that! Squeaky shoes! There you go.
Excuse us.
We can just barely squeak by here.
Oh, oh, sorry.
Why did we come in here anyway?
Must have taken a wrong turn at Albuquerque.
Not everyone can hear with their ears. Elmo has two friends, Alex and Emily. Emily can hear with her ears, and Alex can't. Emily told Elmo all about it.
Yesterday, I went over to my friend Alex's house to play. We played our favorite card game, Go Fish. Alex is deaf, so his ears can't hear. He looks at my lips to see what I'm saying.
Go Fish.
We played a few games, and then we got hungry. Alex's mom asked us what we wanted to eat. She uses sign language to talk to Alex. That's another way he finds out what someone is saying. We had bananas and milk. Alex taught me the sign for banana. And milk. And then we felt like dancing. When we dance, I listen to the music with my ears. And Alex feels the beat with his hands and feet. I bet the fish in the aquarium felt the beat too. I love playing with my friend Alex.
Emily and Alex are very good friends, but now Elmo wants to learn more about ears. How can we find out more? Oh, yeah! We can watch the Ear Channel! Yeah, yeah, yeah. Oh, turn yourself on, TV. Oh. Ooh, TV's all wavy and noisy. That's not good.
What you need is some rabbit ears.
Hey, how's this?
No, still wavy and noisy.
Oh, how about this? Or
no.
This?
No.
How about this?
Oh, yeah. Oh, thanks, buddy.
No problem.
Welcome to the Ear Channel. We're in one ear and out the other, so listen up. It's time for the boy who loved his dog's ears.
Once upon a time, there was a boy who loved his dog's ears.
I love my dog's ears. They're soft and furry.
And they were very useful, too. The dog used his ears for listening. He used his ears for playing peekaboo.
Peekaboo! I love my dog's ears!
He also used his ears to show his feelings. He used his ears to show when he was sad.
Bye, Louie. I have to go to school now.
Sad ears. He used his ears to show when he was happy.
I'm home, Louie.
Happy ears. He used his ears to show when he was surprised.
I have a surprise for you, Louie.
Surprised ears. He used his ears to show when he was sleepy.
Good night, Louie.
Sleepy ears. And of course he used his ears to hold up his glasses.
He did not.
Just kidding.
I love my dog's ears.
And the dog loved the boy's ears too. The end.
Coming up next on the Ear Channel, the best ears of our lives, followed by my favorite ear.
Thanks, Bunny.
Don't mention it.
Oh, thanks, Stevie. You're right. Oh, are you okay, Bunny?
You gotta get cable.
Bye. And now, Elmo wants to hear more about ears, don't you? How can we find out more?
Wanna talk to a dog-eared book?
Yeah! Does Book know a lot about doggy ears?
Sure do. Okay. And other animal ears, too. Mm. That's what I'm about. Animals and their ears.
Wow!
Yeah, take a look.
Okay. Woohoo! Yeah, Bunny! Yeah, bunnies have long ears.
Yep. And some bunnies have long ears that droop way down. See?
Yeah, cool! Oh, look, look, Book! Dorothy's imagining Elmo as a bunny with long, droopy ears. Do your ears hang low? Do they wobble to and fro? Can you tie them in a knot? Can you tie them in a bow? Do they dangle to your toes? Can they wrap around your nose? Do your ears hang low? Whoa! Noisy carrot!
Cats have short, pointy ears, and they keep them very clean.
Meow. Still not clean. Still not clean. Still not... Bubble.
Mice have little round ears.
Squeak. Oh, thank you, Buck.
You're welcome.
Let's hear for ears. Yay! Hey. Elmo loves ears. Oh, and so does Dorothy. That's why Dorothy wants us to sing the ear song. Here we go.
Goodbye!